Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Okay. The screen that
Good afternoon.
No, no.
Okay. So I believe you are quite a number, so I can be able to start.
Okay.
DICT 1A6. When you are going to say my present, you are so many. You are DICT 1A6, 1A3, 1A4, and 1A3. So, oops.
Seven.
Good. 1A4.
And
present.
Good.
Present.
1A3.
Present.
Oh, good. So at least you are all represented. Class reps. Let me start there. 1A3. Hiram.
Present.
1A3 ni? Class lab, sio Hiram?
Hiram, yeah.
Oh, ako, yo, ako. 1A4, An?
Present.
An? Nauliza An, your class lab. Ankiteme. Niye huyo? Eh, I can't hear her.
An,
uko? Okay. 1A6. Class lab 1A6. Are you call? Who is from 1A6? Class? Anyone from?
Yes.
Okay. Let me continue then. Now, because you are somehow represented, I hope you are well there at home and you are still remembering your students. I guess that is why we are here now. Remembering your students?
No.
Who is that?
Yes.
Akubuki? Nimkubushe? Okay. So let's continue. In most of the classes, the reason why I wanted the class lab is because somehow I feel like you are...
Yeah.
Oh, please put off your microphone. Mute them. When you get in or when you join, that your microphone. So that you are able to hear one another. Unless I ask a question, please make sure that your microphones are... or your audio is off or muted. Now, I was saying that in most of the classes, tuliko tumefika process management. Is there a class where hatuko tumefika process management? On Edri? One of you to represent you. 1A3, tulikuwa wapi?
Tulikuwa hapo kwa process management.
Have you started?
No. Tuliguzia tu.
Just mentioning.
Yeah.
1A4. Just one of you. Yes?
Tumeanza process management.
Tukafika wapi?
Tukachora ile diagram.
Process state. Okay. 1A6.
Yeah.
1A6, tulikuwa tumefika wapi?
Kwa process state. Process management. Process state.
So for 1A3 and 1A4, for 1A4 and 1A6, you have to bear with us somehow because we might start again on process management. It is good because you will be reminding yourself. For the sake of 1A3. Have to learn together, and we cannot start where ahead of them, or you cannot be ahead of them. They might not be able to understand clearly. So we are going to like start again at the process management. Hatukuwa tumeenda sana, so I'm just going to start again. 1A3, please listen carefully because I'll be a bit fast. So make sure that you are not left behind. Now, as you can see, the screen that I'm sharing, it is under process management. Remember I said this is one of the functions of the operating system. So, we are going to talk about it. We are going to be able to see how operating system is able to manage processes. Remember what we said about processes? A process is a program in execution, just what is written there. It is a program in execution. People can put their videos off. Huh? so that you avoid seeing one another and some distractions. You can also put your video off a bit. You also make sure that you don't see a lot of data anyway. Now let me continue. Has it a process, a program in education? I had repeated this so many times. That a program, a process is a program in execution, or it is an activity of some kind. I'm reading from that. Kama simu yako hayoni vizuri, you can try to zoom. But I hope it is visible. It is an activity of some kind and has a program code, input, output, and state. So we can also define it as that. An activity of some kind, it has a program code, it has input, it has output, it has state. When you are talking of program code, what we mean is those instructions. When you are adikiana hatutaki kukuona, please avoid those messages unless it is to clear, to make something clear concerning what you are learning about. Please avoid some messages. Now let me continue. Please avoid anything that is distractive, because sitaki kukuwa distracted. So I said it is an activity of some kind and has program code, input, output, and state. Now this is going to keep on distracting me. Kwasababu sasa somebody is writing to me that the screen is not visible on their side. Is it visible? Mnaiona?
Yes.
Yeah, inaonekana vizuri.
I don't know who has written that to me, but ajaribu kuzoom. Hata kuna mwenye anakuandikia hapo. Try zoom so that you will be able to see. I hope you have understood what I have said. Try to zoom just like the way you can zoom a picture. Try to zoom that screen. You'll be able to see it clearly. Now, let me also make this clear. If it is a question or it is something that is meant to come to me, but I yate kukua message, just say excuse so that I don't keep on looking at the messages that you are writing. Sasa, ili tuate kukua na distraction. If it is supposed to come to me, let it not be a message. Nisikae nikisoma soma message and then I'm distracted now and then. Just the excuse and I will first of all stop. Okay, let me repeat again. We are in process management and I have said we have been defining the word process from the time we started. So I'm sure by now you already know what a process is. A program in execution, or we can also say it is an activity of some kind and has program code, input, output, and state. I was explaining program code. Program code are those instructions. Like when you open a Microsoft Word document, it has some instruction. It has the menus. Those ones are the instructions. It has those like home, insert. Those ones are instructions. So us as the user, we are able to give a program some instruction to do that. So those ones are what we call program code. Then it has input. Input is what we enter as the user. It has output, what we expect to get after processing, and state. State, I'm not going to explain it at this point because of when you have zafika hapo. When you have zafika hapo kwa process state, it might not be so clear to them at this point, but you'll understand it. So that is also meant to explain what is a process. Now, components of a process. So a process is composed of this one object program that is the code to be executed. And this one I'll also repeat again, it is the instructions. The codes to be executed or the instructions to be executed is what we are calling the object program. Data is what we as the user we enter so that it can be executed. Resources, I have been mentioning this from the time we also started learning about operating system. Resources is what a process needs in order to finish execution. Like it needs CPU, it needs memory, it may need input or output devices. Those ones are resources. Status of the process execution, that is the state at which the process is. This one I have said, I don't want to explain so much because of those who we have not learned about process state, but I'll mention this. It's a particular process is usually in different states. I'm going to run them down there, so just wait so that we learn about them. So those ones are the components, data, resources, and status. Those are the components of a process, what it is composed of. Now, because we have been talking of a process and a program, I want us to see the comparison between the two of them so that it is easier for us to be able to differentiate what is a program, what is a process. I say it to some classes, I'm repeating to others, it is their first time to hear this. So comparison between a process and a program. So a program, it is a set of instructions in programming language. So whenever you install a particular program, ama app, kwa simu yako, it is in form of instructions. So it is a program, it is an app. But when it comes to a process, whenever you open that app or a program and you want to do something with it, it stops being a program temporarily, it becomes a process because it is in execution. That is why we have written there under the process, sequence of instruction in execution. So when it starts, when a program starts being executed, somehow temporarily it stops being a program, it is now referred to as a process because it is under execution. So that is one of the differences. The other one is program is a static object that exists in a file. Static. Static is something that remains the same. So wakatum, we are using something like Microsoft Word. When you use it, then you close it, you use it again, then you close it. It does not change in terms of zile menus, ikonayo, home, insert, all those things, they still remain the same. As in, they don't change. But when it comes to a process, because remember a process is a program in execution, it means the process will keep on changing. Today you will do this with Microsoft Word, tomorrow you will do something else. So it will keep on changing. So we are saying a process is a dynamic object. Why are you saying it is dynamic? Because it is a program in execution. So to what you will execute today is not what you will execute tomorrow. So that's why we are saying it is dynamic. Another difference is a program is loaded into secondary storage. Well, the process is loaded into main memory. Wakati a program is installed, it is loaded into secondary storage, like a hard disk. Whenever you install something into the computer, it goes to the hard disk. It is a program, so it is stored in the hard disk. Whenever you open a program, I remember I have been saying this in all classes. Whenever you open a program, it moves from the secondary storage, it goes to the main memory. So, because you are executing, it has to be in the main memory. And therefore, at that particular point, it is a process, not a program. So when it is in the main memory, it is a process because it is being executed at that particular point. So that is another difference. A program is in secondary storage, but the process is in main memory. The other one is a program, its lifespan is unlimited. Well, under the process, lifespan is limited. Why are you saying that a program lifespan is unlimited? Because a program, when you install it into the computer, it will be there for a very long time. Unless you uninstall, it will remain there. So its lifespan is not limited, it is unlimited. But a process, because it is a program in execution, whenever a program, I have said it becomes a process. Whenever you close it, so that's why we are saying the lifespan of a process is limited. Because when you close the program, when you finish whatever you are doing and you close, that process is gone. You will not have that process again. The data will remain, but that the work of that process is gone. So that's why we are saying it's life limited. So that is it. That's another difference. That a program entity, well, an active entity. Remember, we have said that a program is usually in the secondary. Yeah, that's why we are calling it passive. But when it comes to us, because it is being executed, the program in execution, since it is being executed, it is therefore active. So that's another difference. A process is active, so whenever it is being executed, it is of course active. But a program is passive. That is an opposite of the word active. So I hope you have been able to get those differences. Those differences can be a bit complex if you take it that way, but at the same time they can help you to literally understand the difference between a process and a program. So I just want to hope that everybody has been able to understand the differences. Is there a question on that? A process and a program question? Yes? Somebody was putting on the microphone. I don't know whether they had a question or what. But I hope it is understandable, especially to Anet. I'm repeating this because of you, so I hope you have been able to understand. So we go to what we call process state. Remember when I was saying about the components of a process, I have said project,
data, resources, and status, all state. So these ones are the states. When we talk about process state, what exactly do we mean? Process state is defined as the current activity of the process. So the current activity, what is it that a process is doing? So that is what defines its state. At what state is it in? So what is its current activity? We said this, a life cycle of a process can be divided into several states, each state having its own characteristic that define the process. So that life cycle, because a process has from the time it was created the time it is terminated, that's why we are calling it a life cycle. We are saying that life cycle can be divided into several states. And each of these states is defining or is giving the characteristic of that particular process. A process can be in any of the following states. So these are the states of a process. It can be in any of the following.
or it can be carrying out these activities in these stages. One is new. Process is being created. So when a process is being created, we call it a new process. Just like everything. After the time you entered into the college, you were new. So everything has the time that it is new. So even a process here, when it is being created, we call it a new process. From there, it is loaded into the memory, and therefore we call it a ready process. So when it is loaded into memory, we call it a ready process. When it was being created, it was a new process. When it is loaded into memory, it is a ready process. It is ready, waiting to be allocated the CPU or the processor. So ready, waiting to be assigned to a processor. Remember, the CPU is the one that carries the processing or data processing. So already waiting to be allocated the processor, but it is already in the main memory. From ready, we have running state. Running, in this case, instructions are being executed. So when processing is being done, we say that a process is in running state. So data is being executed. Data processing is being carried out. So that process is in running state. The other one, before I explain waiting, let me first of all explain terminated. When a process has finished whatever it was doing, it goes to termination. So it was running, and of course it has done whatever it was supposed to do. With that, it has to finish. So when it is finishing or it has finished, it is called a terminated process. But there are some programs that don't move from the running to termination state. They go to what we call waiting state. Why do they go to the waiting state? Because maybe a program, or I mean a process, was requiring a particular input or output device, and therefore it has to wait for it to be ready. In the classes that I taught, I gave this example. If you are using a Word document, so you opened it, and now you typed whatever you have typed, you wanted to type, and you are through, and the last thing you wanted is to print, so you need a printer. A printer is an output device. If that printer is not ready, you have to wait for the printer to be ready. So it means that when you are waiting for the printer to be ready, the process has to be put in the waiting state. So we say that a process is in the waiting state when it is waiting for some event to occur, like what I have said, waiting for the printer to be ready. So it is waiting for a particular event to occur. So it has to be put in the waiting state. So those ones are the different or the life cycle of a process. It starts from being new, it is loaded into memory, it becomes ready, it is allocated the CPU, it becomes running, it can either terminate or go to the waiting if it is requiring a particular input or output device. So those ones are the states. And remember what I have said at the beginning. Process state defines the current activity of the process. So as you can see, in all these five states, it is defining the current activity. What is it that process, or what is it that the process is doing at a particular state? If it is new, of course, it has just been created. If it is ready, it is loaded into memory, waiting for the processor. If it is running, it means it is being executed. If it is waiting, it is waiting for an event to occur. If it is terminated, it means that it has executed. So those ones are activity of a process. And in simple terms, we have that diagram that can literally show clearly now what is happening, all those states. I want to believe that you can be able to see it. I said, if you are not seeing clearly, just zoom. You'll be able to clearly see. Try to zoom your diagram or that, whatever the screen, you'll be able to see. So the first state you have said it's new. It has just been created. So it is a new process. It is, when it is admitted, to admit, we mean that it has been loaded into the memory. So it becomes ready. So it stops being a new process, it becomes a ready process. Now, from a ready process, there is an arrow that has been left there that is supposed to read from, oh, okay, I have seen it, it is down there. Moving from the ready to the running. I explained this in those classes and I'm going to repeat again. I said, in new process, we can have so many processes. Or in new state, we can have so many processes. We can have process one, process two, process three, so many of them. In ready state, I said we can also have so many processes. Process one, process two, process three, so many of them. But when we are moving from the ready to the running state, we can only have one process. Because it is only one process that is executed at a time. So only one process is executed at a time. So in the running state, I'm repeating again in those classes I had said, we can only have one process at a time. So that is running. So from ready to running, a process is being executed. You can see there is an arrow moving from the running state back to the ready state, and up there it is written interrupt. So up there it is written interrupt. Now, a user can interrupt a program when it is being executed. Maybe you had given a particular command, but somehow you want to undo it, you want to change things. Maybe you press a key like escape or something like that. You are trying to stop the execution of a process. So you are interrupting. So when the user interrupts, when a process is running, it goes back to the ready state. So that is why you can see up there it is written interrupt. So those ones are caused by the user. A user can interrupt a process and it is being executed. So it is just going to move from that to the ready state. Still again, you can see an arrow moving from the running to waiting. Remember what I have said? If an example I have given, you wanted to print, but the printer is not ready, so you will have to wait for some moment. That process is moved from the running state to the waiting state. And you can see there, that is written input or output wait. So it is waiting for an input or an output or a particular event to occur. So it has to be put in the waiting area because it cannot continue to hold the CPU when it is in the waiting state or when it needs something else. So it has to release the CPU. Therefore, it is taken to the waiting area. When it has acquired an input stroke output, it is taken back to the ready state. So it cannot go to the running state again. It is taken back to the ready state. So I stroke O or event completion takes it back to the ready state. So it is at the ready state where it will be given the CPU again to continue running. So you can see what I was saying about the waiting. So if a particular event was new, then event to running, see lazima you had the waiting, it is not a must. It can go direct to termination. So a process can go to new, ready, running, then termination. It is not a must that it has to go to waiting, but some processes go into the waiting state. So termination, you can see there from running, it is exit. Therefore, it means that the process has finished or has completed whatever it was supposed to complete, and therefore it has to be terminated. And that is when, of course, you are able to close even your program after you are through with whatever you are doing, and of course you are done. So that is another state, terminated state, that a process has completed whatever it was supposed to. So that is a simple diagram explaining the process state. And I repeat again, I say the process state, it is the current activity of a particular process. Is it understandable? Or have you understood? Hata wanyo nilikuwa nime explain here before. Are you still there?
Yes.
Okay. Anyone with a question?
We are here.
Okay. Anyone with a question? Up to the where we have stopped? Okay, I want to believe that it is you have been able to understand. Now from here, sidhani kuna watu tulikuwa tumepita hapa, although I feel like kuna group nilikuwa wamepita hapa kidogo, but let me still continue. This is a continuation and it is an NB, something to note. Only one process can be running on any processor at any instant. Let's first of all stop there. Only one process can be running on any processor at any instant. That's what I have said. Only one process can be in the running state. Only one. You may explain hapo better as I was showing you the diagram. Only one process can be in the running state. We can have so many processes in the new state. We can have so many processes in the ready state. We can have so many processes in the waiting state. But there can only be one process in the running state. That means that it is only one process that can be using the CPU at one particular time. We have two or more processes in the running state. We can only have one. Still, in the continuation of that, many processes may be in ready and waiting state. That's what I have said. You can have so many processes in the ready state. You can have so many processes in the waiting state. But I want you to note this, only one process can be in the running state. The other thing to note, only processes in the ready queue can be assigned a processor. That is another thing to note. Only processes in the ready queue or in the ready state can be assigned a processor. So we cannot take a process from the new state to the running state. That cannot happen. Take a process from the waiting state to the running state. That cannot happen. A process can only move from the ready state to the running state. Because it is at the ready state where they wait for to be given the CPU. So when they have been given the CPU, it starts executing. So that is also something to note. Only processes in the ready queue can be assigned a processor. The other thing, well, another thing to note, when a process needs to use the processor, it has to wait for the OS to assign it. Let me repeat that again. When a process needs to use the processor, it has to wait for the OS to assign it. The processor is the CPU. I keep on repeating this so that people are not confused. Processor is the CPU. So it is only OS or operating system can that can be able to assign a particular process, that can be able to assign CPU to a particular process. It is only OS that can be able to assign CPU to a particular process. Nothing else can be able to assign, assign that. That's why we are talking of process management as a function of operating system, because it is the one that is managing the processes. Remember, Tukianza, when we are talking of the functions of operating system, said the activities that the CPU does when it comes to process management is, this one, in fact, I should be asking you so that you remind me, so that people don't keep quiet so much. I'm asking this, when we are talking of the functions of operating system, we said the following activities are carried out under process management. So, what is one of those activities? So, I'm waiting for you to answer that. So, what are some of these activities?
It allocates the processor to a process.
Yes, it allocates a processor to a process. Another one?
Keeps track of the processor and status of the process.
Yes, keeps track of the status of the processor status and the state of a process. The other one?
It deallocates
processor when a process is no longer required.
Yes, deallocates the processor when the of course when the process has terminated. Now those ones I said they are the three activities that the OS carries out. So this one, that's I have told you to repeat, because we say it allocates. So it means that it is the work of the OS to be able to allocate processor to any particular process. So those are three things that you should note. Only one process can be in the running state, but you can have so many processes in the other states. Only processes in the ready queue can be assigned to the processor, and it is only OS that can assign processor to the process. Now, remember we have talked of the waiting state. So it is somehow when you are talking of the waiting state, we say that that process has been suspended in a way. So it has put somewhere waiting. So we say that it is suspended. So what is a suspended process? It is a process that has been put on hold for a particular event to occur. It is a process that has been put on hold for a particular event to occur. So that process that is waiting, it means that it has been put on hold. So it is going to wait for something to occur. So what are some of the characteristics of the processes that are suspended? One, suspended process is not immediately available for execution. So it is not available at the moment for execution. So it has to wait for an event to occur or for a particular thing to happen so that it can be ready. So it is not immediately available for execution. Its characteristic is that the process may or may not be waiting for an event to occur. Here we are saying it may be waiting for an event to occur, but at the same time, it can still be put in the waiting area without waiting for a particular event to occur. Why? Maybe the time that it was given to execute has ended, so it has to be put in the waiting area. So it means that it will be there waiting. So we are saying it is not a must that it can be waiting for an input or an output device. It can still be put in a waiting area, maybe with some more time to use the CPU. So we are saying may or may not be waiting for an event. change to the characteristic. For preventing the execution, process is suspended by the OS, the parent process, or process itself, and an agent. So what suspends a process? This point is talking about that process, or what makes it go to the waiting area. So it can go to the waiting area because the OS has made it to go there. That means the OS has stopped execution of that process, and therefore it has to be put in the waiting area. Remember, the operating system can be able to do that to any process. It can stop execution of any process at any particular time. So OS can stop it. Another thing that can stop it is the parent process. Remember I said there are parent processes and there are child processes. Child processes have been born from the parent. This is like how we are as human beings. We have parent and of course there are children. Which is when it comes to processes, there are parent processes and there are child processes. So a parent process can stop execution of a child process. So also that can also happen. Or the process itself, it can stop itself. It can just stop. We are saying for execution to stop, a process is suspended by the OS, the parent process, or the process itself. When it has been suspended, it means that if it was suspended by the OS, it is only the OS that can remove it from the waiting area. If it was suspended by the parent process, it is only the parent process that can take it from the waiting area. That goes to the fourth point. Process may be removed from the suspended state and orders the agent, either the OS, the parent process, or the process itself. So it cannot be removed from the suspended area or suspended state unless the agent that took it there removes it from there. Number five, another characteristic is swapping is used to move a process from the main memory to disk. Swapping, I don't know whether I explained in all classes, but I remember saying this in some classes. Swapping is where, in fact, I remember in one of the classes I explained with the two ladies that we are sitting there in front, and I said, if you want to move one person from this seat and give it to another person, the person who was sitting must first of all wake up so that the other one can sit. That's what happens. If you want to remove a process from the running state, you have to and bring another one to the running state. You have to first of all put one in the waiting area so that the other one can come from the ready state to the running. That one we call it swapping. So you are removing one from this place and giving that place to another one. So we are talking of swapping there. So the processes have to swap. So that is another characteristic. Swapping is used to move a process from main memory to disk, to the disk. So those ones are some of the characteristics of a suspended process. We got to reason for process suspension. So what can cause a process to be suspended? One is swapping, just what I have explained when I was talking of the characteristic swapping. Swapping is moving one thing from here and taking it to another place so that another one can come and fit in its place. So you are swapping them, you are trying to interchange, let me use this one word, interchanging. This can be moved to the suspension state because they are being interchanged. There is some form of interchanging that is taking place. So one of the reasons is swapping. OS needs to release the required main memory to bring in a process
that is ready to execute. So because one process was using the main memory, it has to be taken away from the main memory so that another one can come and occupy the main memory. So they are just like interceding, swapping. Another reason why a process can be suspended or put in the waiting is timing. Process may be suspended while waiting for the next time interval. I remember I said this in almost every class. When processes are using the CPU, what they use is the time, CPU time. What does that mean? They are allocated a particular amount of time to use the CPU. And when that time is over, that process has to stop so that another one can be given time to use the CPU. So that's why we see things happening so fast. Because when it comes to the computer, things work in terms of time. All processing is done in terms of time. Allocation of time slot. So if a process was running and its time is over, that is the time it was allocated to use the CPU is over, it has first of all to be put in the waiting area and another process will come and be executed. So it is put in the waiting area, waiting to be allocated some more time. I'll explain that a bit and say this. If a process was given 5 minutes to execute, in fact, let's talk of second because execution happens in terms of second. If it is given 5 seconds to execute, when 5 seconds are over, even if it had not finished, the CPU has to be taken away. So that's one of the reasons why it can be put in the waiting area, because it is time is over. Another one is interactive user request. Process may be suspended for the debugging purposes by the user. That is why it is being called interactive user request. So the user interrupts. So you may have been trying something in the computer, and then somehow you notice that you did not want to things to happen that way, or you are changing a document in some way, and then you notice that you did not want things to happen that way. Maybe you try undoing or pressing escape so that things stop, so that you can cancel. That is a user request. The user has requested that the OS cancels whatever was happening. So that a user can request for a process to be suspended. So whenever you cancel something in the computer, it means that you have given a request to the computer for it to stop doing whatever it was doing. And therefore, whatever process that was executing has to be put in the waiting area until the user requests again for something to happen. The other reason why a process can be terminated is parent process request. So I said there is a parent process and there is child processes. So it means that child processes are at the parent. So if the parent requests termination of a child process or it requests suspension of a child process, it must be suspended. So a parent process can request for a child process to be suspended. So that is another reason why suspension can come in. So those ones are the four reasons: swapping, timing, interactive user request, or parent process request. So those four reasons are the one that can make a process to be suspended or put in the waiting area. Because I have said it is the same as being put in the waiting area, being put at hold. So I believe now we are all together. Hapa hakuna group ilikuwa imefika hapa kwa suspension. I believe there is a group that we had gone up to that far. But now from here, all the groups are supposed to be here at this particular point. So remember, I mentioned there above. Let me go back. Somehow I'll keep on going back. I said a process has components. What it is made up of? Object, program, data, resources, and status. You have seen all those things. So I'm going to what we are calling, we call process control block. Process control block. This one, I'm going to explain it as a, so that for easy understanding, but don't get this definition. I'm just saying for easy understanding. It is like a file or a storage place where information about a particular process is stored. So process control block stores information of a particular process. We call it PCB. PCB is the data structure used by the operating system to store information about each and every process. You in school, there is a file that contains information about you, about another person, about another person. So whenever you will go and request, you can be given a file that contains information about you. The same case when it comes to computer, the operating system keeps track or keeps information about each and every process. And that information is kept in the process control block. So it is, we just define it as a data structure used by the OS to store information about each process. OS groups all information that needs it needs about a particular process, that it needs about a particular process. So it usually keeps information about each and every process. Now, each process contains its own process block. So there is no process block for all processes together. No, each and every process has its own process control block. I said in the beginning, for simple understanding, I can just call it like a file. So each and every process has its own file. But I'm using the word file. It is not formal, just an informal word for you to be able to understand. So each and every process has its own form. It has its own PCB, process control block, that keeps its information. The PCB simply serves as the repository for any information that may vary from process to process. Process or PCB also includes the information about the CPU scheduling, input, output, resource management, file management information, priority, and so on. So it does not only keep information about a particular process in terms of the states, all those things, it also keeps the CPU scheduling. At what time is that process supposed to use the CPU and how much time? Of course, it also puts information about which input or output resources does a particular process requires. What are the files that it is supposed to use? And then lastly, the priority. Is it of high priority or of low priority? So it has to indicate, is a particular process of high priority or of low priority? So those ones are some of the information that is kept in the PCB. I've said the PCB just keeps information about a particular process. So process control block or the PCB contains the following. So we are talking of the content of the PCB. One is the pointer. Pointer points to to another process control block. Pointer is used for maintaining scheduling list. Pointer is like this. I'll say this. You know, there are so many processes. And execution has to move from one process to another, then to another, then to another. So if process 2 is the one that is executing, and what is going to follow is process 3, then that information has to be indicated that the next process to be executed is process 3. So a pointer points to the next process that is to be executed. So that is one of the information that is usually in the PCB. The other one is the process state. So at what state is the process, or what is the current activity of a process? It may be new, ready, running, waiting. Tumesoma hizo. So also, that is another content that must be there. Program counter, it indicates the address of the current instruction to be executed for this process. For a process to execute, of course, it requires some instructions. So it needs to keep track of the instructions that are to be executed. So every instruction that is to be executed must be indicated in the process control block on the PCB. That is another content. The instructions that are to be executed. The other one is the event information. For a process in the block state, this field contains information concerning the event for which the process is waiting. This one is not in every process. I have to mention this. Event information is not in every process because it is information about any blocked or any suspended process. So it has to indicate if this process is in suspension state, why is it there? Is it waiting for an input or an output device? For more time slot? That is what must be indicated. That is the event information. What event is it waiting for it executing? Continuation of that, CPU register, it indicates general purpose register, stack pointers, index register, accumulators, etc. Isn't the summer for introduction to computer? I don't want to dwell on them so much. And you'll be learning about the CPU. You'll be learning that there are some registers that are usually in the CPU. And they are the ones that are indicated there. Kuna accumulator register, kuna index registers. Hizo mtasoma at that particular point. Hamjafika hapo, I'm quite sure. But you'll read about them in introduction to computer. So some information about the CPU must also be kept in there. The other one is memory management information. So this indicates the amount of memory that this process is going to require in order to run until termination. So this is useful because when you need to deallocate the memory, you will need to know how much are you deallocating. So information about memory, the amount of memory a particular process requires, must also be there. The last one is accounting information. This information includes the amount of CPU, drift time used, time limits, job or process numbers, account numbers, etc. So this is all about the information about the CPU. This one indicates how much time does this process require to use the CPU, and what is the limit time that it can be given. So how much does it require and how much can it be given, or will it be given at a particular point? So that is the accounting information. So this one we are saying are the contents of the PCB. And I said PCB, it is like a file keeping information about a particular process. And I have given you an example. Each and every student in the college has their own file. Nakubuka mkikuja, you are giving your files and all that. That file contains some information about you. So it has name, it has class, it has course, it has all those things. So the same case, when it comes to a process, it has its own file. And that file, we are calling it the PCP. And the word file, I'm using it just for your understanding. We have defined what this is. We have said it is a data structure used by the OS to store information. But the word file, I'm using it for you to be able just to understand easily. So when we are talking of the CPU, the PCB, process control block, it is that part that is used to store information about a particular process. Now, because I can't see you, I can only hope that you can be able to see or ask whether there is a question. Any question, or have you understood? Sawa. So I'm just hoping you are understanding, because now these online classes, they are good, but the problem is that people cannot see one another, so I cannot be able to know whether people are listening, whether they are understanding. I'm just hoping. Now, yes, I'm just hoping, because I can only hope. But for your sake, I hope you are listening, because this is not something that you are going to repeat again. Just treat them like normal classes. In fact, it is better, because uko hapo peke yako, nobody can be able to distract you. Studio. So somehow, it is better in that way. But for the trainer, it is not so good, because for us, we want to see whether you are understanding. Now, because I can't see you, I may not be able to know. Just as I have said, I can only be able to hope. So, nani huyo ameandika it is bad.
Nashanga. Classroom.
Man.
Iko bad.
Anne,
I'll
make
up a screenshot up.
Anne, that's a funny again. And I'll be catching. So, you know, I wanted to know what is bad. Anne, Sibasi Wadike, what is bad?
Yes, Malim.
You see, Anne.
Tuendelee tu.
Ah, kuna mtu ameuliza swali. Sasa, sir, do you want me to keep on reading these messages? Surely. Si nimesema mtu aniambie excuse na aulize swali, kwa sababu nao this one is asking mwalimu aburudisha pale. Sasa ni nini narudisha? Oh, ama ni the screen pale kwa CPU register, kuna point nataka kuandika. Oh, okay, hapo iko hapo. Sasa umeona? Some are sleeping. Oh, ndio maana unasema ni kubaya.
Screenshot is
easy. Here it is.
Yes.
Yes, of course it is good to be in school.
Hello. Hello.
In fact, even for me, I prefer to
school. Well, you know, I'm here, man.
And it's seriously? Now, of course, even for me, it is better when we are in school, because when we are in school, I can be able to see all of you, and I can be able to see what you are doing, and whether you are understanding. You see, when I look at you, I'm able to know whether you can hear or you are getting something. But now here, as I have said, I can only hope. But now, what can we do? Sasa mtakosa kusoma mpaka corona iishe ama hii maneno irudi vizuri. Are you going to wait?
Mm.
Na ikikaa mwaka mzima?
Ngoja.
Na goa hizi kubali mwaka mzima tena.
Of course, hata kubali but now. Mm. The others also, they didn't know that watakaa mwaka mzima. And the year was
wasted. Mambo Vanessa.
Somebody is just telling you when you are wananini amewaandikia hapo how they can just repeat the module. Now who is that? Okay, let's just bear with it. It will be just for some time, and then if you go, maybe by May tutarudi shule. Whatever somebody has not understood, you can ask. But for now, we have to nini. We have to bear with that. Yes, mmoja amekuandikia have some courtesies. But let's wacha tuachane na mambo na kuandika. We continue. Sasa huyo I was speaking. Hey, listen. I was speaking and I was waiting for this. Mwenye alikuwa ameniambia nikae nirudishe screen hapo kwa register to be able to write. I hope ameweza. Kosawa. So okay.
Kosawa.
Now we go to something we call process scheduling. Remember from where we started process management, what I have been explaining is a process. What is a process? Process state, PCB, I have said it is that where information about a process is stored. So I have been explaining somehow what is a process and all that things about a process. Now when it comes to scheduling, this is the exact thing that the OS does. Scheduling processor to the CPU. So we need somehow to be able to understand what is process scheduling. Process scheduling is a mechanism. Scheduling mechanism is part of the process manager that handles removal of the running process from the CPU and the selection of another process on the basis of a particular strategy. So I'll just put it this way in simple terms. It is that part of the OS that does process management or that handles the removal of one process from the CPU and gives another process the CPU. It uses some strategies that we are going to learn as we go on. But I want to insist this, when we are talking of scheduling, it is what the OS does, giving one process the CPU, then it waits for it to execute, then it awaits what we are calling the allocation, and then it allocates another process the CPU like that. So it has to keep on giving one process a CPU, taking it away, then giving another one and taking it away. That is what we are calling process scheduling. So processes are being scheduled. Scheduled what? The CPU or the processor. So they are being given time with the CPU. That is what we call process scheduling. We can also do it this way. It is the process of switching the CPU among processes. So switching the CPU among processes. giving the CPU to this one, taking it away, giving it to this one, taking it away, like that. That is allocation, deallocation, allocation, deallocation, like that. Makes the computer more productive and is the basis of multi-programming OS. Normally, several processes are kept in memory, and when one process has to wait, the OS takes the CPU away from the process and gives the CPU to another process. It is just keeping on repeating and explaining exactly what that is. Hiram, I hope you are listening. Sio mabazako tu unafanya. Apona huyo sio Hiram. No, that is not Hiram. Who is this? Mother. Mother?
Yes.
Isn't it vitu gani unafanya sasa? Are you listening?
Yes.
Sasa hiyo rope ni ya nini sasa?
Ani ya kuna.
That's how I was saying Zima video that I don't see that. Not that I wouldn't want to see you, but I might be distracted. Mute the volume and also turn off the video. Now, I was explaining about scheduling, and that is it. And we have talked of something on the basis of let me just mute her. I don't know whether she's unable to mute herself. I'm muting people who are not muting themselves so that we are able to listen to one another. Now, I was saying this. When you're talking of multi-programming OS, I remember I mentioned this in some of the classes, but mostly I gave it as an assignment. I hope you were able to do it. So, because if you have not done it, it might be hard for you to understand this. Now, multi-programming is where you are able to run more than one program at a particular point. What happens is the issue of time. This one is allocated some few minutes, then this one like that, we see like it is. So our programs that are running at the same time, but of course what is happening is that they are being allocated some amount of time with the CPU, then it is taken away, given to another one like that. So process scheduling is good when it comes to multi-programming, because too many programs can be able to run at the same time. They can be able to use the CPU at the same time. What happens is that they are allocated some amount of time with the CPU. So I hope you have been able to know what is process scheduling. Is that allocation of the CPU to a particular process. That's allocation and deallocation, of course. Scheduling queues. When we are talking of queues ni line, hiyo kupaga. Sasa hiyo, nilisema, so many processes can be in the ready state, but only one process can be in the running state. So many processes can be in the waiting state, but only one process can be in the running state. So, when we are talking of queues is either in ready state or in waiting state. That's where we have queue. Queue is here, is also many processes waiting. So I said processes can be waiting in ready state and they can be waiting in waiting state. But only one can be in the running state. So these queues that are either in ready state or waiting state, they are two. They are two. So let me first of all read this. When process enters into the system, they are put in a job queue or process queue. This queue consists of processes in the system. The OS has
other cues. So it has other cues. Other than those ones that are in the ready state or have just been admitted, they are other cues. Types of scheduling cues. Types of cues. One, ready queue. Ready queue, you will now realize that it is in the ready state. See, ready queue is in the ready state. So many processes that are waiting for to be given the CPU. So that queue they are forming in the ready queue, in the ready state, is what we call the ready queue. Those processes waiting to be allocated the CPU. So we can say ready queue is a newly arrived process is put in the ready queue. So when a process is new, it has arrived, now admitted, it is put in the ready queue. Processes are waiting in ready queue for allocation of the CPU. So when they are in the ready queue state, that queue they are forming, we are calling it the ready queue. They are waiting to be given the CPU. So when one has been given the CPU, it leaves the ready queue and it goes to the running state. So it is executing. Processes in the ready queue are waiting to be allocated the CPU. That is what I want to insist. So once the CPU is assigned to the process, then the process will execute. There is another queue we call device queue. It's a queue for a list of processes waiting for a particular input or output. Remember what I have said there above? I have said we can have so many processes in the ready queue, we can have so many processes in the waiting queue. So those ones in the waiting queue are waiting either for an input or an output. Waiting queue are waiting for an input or an output device. So we call them device queue. So those ones that are in the waiting state, we call it a device queue. Those ones that are in the ready state, waiting for the CPU, we call it a ready queue. So it is just ready, waiting to be given the CPU. Device queue, they are waiting for input or an output device. So they are ready queue. So we have those two types of queue, ready queue and device queue. And that is why I said at the beginning, we can have so many processes in the ready state, and we can have so many processes in the waiting state. So those ones in the waiting state are device queue. Those ones in the ready state are ready queue. But I repeat here again, only one process can be in the running state. So there we don't have a queue. We have only one process. So there is no queue when it comes to the running state. But in the ready state, we have a ready queue. In the waiting state, we have a device queue. Hope it is understandable. So when it comes to scheduling, the OS is looking at those ones in the ready queue, and also it is scheduling or giving the CPU to those ones in the device queue. It can give, it keeps balance, it has to keep a balance. Keep on giving those in the ready queue and of course those ones in the, when a device is ready, those ones in the ready, device queue, sorry. I hope you have been able to understand those two queues, because remember, scheduling, nimesema, it is that process of giving a CPU to a particular process, then taking it away and giving it to the next process, like that. So those processes that are in a queue are the ones that are scheduled, or that are the ones that are allocated the CPU. And I have said we can have those two queues. Continuation, NB. Well, a process is executing, it means that it is in the running state. One of the following events may occur. So when a process is running or is executing, one of the following events may occur. One, the process could issue an input or output request and then placed in an input or output queue, or what we have called the device queue. So if it it requests for an input or an output, for an input or an output device, yes, it was executing, then request to the waiting area. So it goes to the waiting state. Another thing that can happen, we have said one of these, so it is not a must that it can happen, but it can. So the other thing is, the process could create a new sub-process and wait for its termination. So remember when I was talking about the parent process and child process. So you are saying a process, if it was executing, it can create sub-processes or what we can call child processes. So when it creates execute and then it goes to termination. It means that when it creates child processes, it is going to be put in the waiting area. No, it is not. It is just going to finish very fast. So that is another thing that can happen to a process that was executed. It can just finish whatever it was doing and then terminate. Another thing that can happen, the process could be removed forcibly from the CPU as a result of interrupt and put back in the ready queue. So we are saying when a process is executing, another thing that can happen to it, if it is interrupted, the CPU can be taken away from it and it can be put back in the ready queue. I want to explain this by this diagram when we are talking of the process state. I'm going back there. I hope you look here very carefully because this is what we'll explain. You see where it is written running. Running state is where we are saying executing state. So we call it running, not executing, but we say that the program at that particular time is executing. So what we are talking about, we are saying when a program or a process is executing, three can happen. One, we have said if it requests for an input stroke output, it is going to be put in the waiting area. I hope you can see an arrow moving from the running state to the waiting state. So that is one thing that can happen. It can move from the running state to the waiting state, waiting for an input or an output to be given to it. Another thing can happen, if it is not put in the waiting area, another thing can happen. When it is in the running state, I'll try to move the mouse that it is able for you to understand. When it is just here in the running state, if it does not go to the waiting, then it can finish whatever it was doing and just terminate. You can see the arrow moving from the running state to the termination state. So that is another thing that can happen. When a process was executing, it can finish and terminate. Another thing that can happen, when a process is running or executing, it can also be interrupted by the user. Remember what we said. It can be interrupted by the user and goes back to the ready state. So those ones are the three things that can happen to a running or executing process. It can either move to the waiting area, waiting for input or output. It can either finish whatever it was doing and terminate, or it can just be interrupted and go back to the ready state. That is just what I was trying to say. So those are the NBs that I was trying to explain. When a process is executing, it can, those three things may occur. Now, I want this to be the last thing that I'm going to explain, so that because it is the first lesson, people can go and digest on what we have talked about. Process operation.
which is the last thing that I'm going to explain. So I hope people can just listen a bit. Naona watu wakireft, that is why I'm saying that. People keep on. I hope it is not the issue of network. But people can just listen for some few minutes and then... There are various operations that can be done to a process. These include, so some of the things that can happen when you're talking of a process is process creation. So for it to exist, it must be created. When it has finished whatever it was doing, it is destroyed. Therefore, an operation that can occur is destroy process. When it has terminated, it is destroyed. Before it is terminated, another operation can happen is run process. So executing, this is what we mean. Another operation that can occur is change process priority. If it was low priority, it can be changed to be of high priority. My priority will be coming to look at them later on, you will be able to understand. But they can change either from to high priority, but they cannot change from high to low. They can only change from low to high priority. So another thing can happen is to get the process information. So you can just gather the or the OS can gather the process information and then set it. Set it where? At the PCB. Remember, PCB is the one that keeps information about a process. So those are some of the operations that can happen to a process. A process can be created, a process can be destroyed, a process can run, a process can change priority, a process information can be set or can be gathered or can be set. Those ones are operations that can happen. But next time when you come, because I don't want to go to this because it is somehow it can some few details there. We are going to talk of the main operations because they are two, as highlighted there. Hapo bele, tumeona there are so many things that can happen. All these things can happen to a process, or all these operations that can happen to a process. But the two main ones are these ones. I'm just going to mention and then we are going to look at them. So these ones can happen. There is process creation and there is process termination. These ones are the two main. A process must be created and must be terminated. So these ones must happen. Even if they are the middle, others may fail to happen, but it must be created and must be terminated. So those ones are the things that can happen, or the two main operations that can happen. But up there, we have seen there are so many that can happen, but these ones are the two main. Now, we are going to discuss them in the next lesson. We are going to discuss them in detail, and we are going to see that. So I hope you have been able to understand. I have said it may not be better like face-to-face, but everything is about the attitude. The attitude you put in it, you want to run, yes, you can be able to run. But now, if you keep on looking at the issue of it is online, then it will be harder for you. So just try to have a good attitude to add it, and you'll be able to run. Is there a question?
Yes.
Yes.
Niko na swali. Hizi notes tumetumia kufunza ni the same na ile PDF ulitutumianga?
Yes, it is the same. I have just shortened them.
Oh.
But anyway, I can still send them for easy understanding. I have just shortened because natumia PowerPoint, but it is the same.
Okay.
But nitawatumia pia hii for easy understanding.
Thank you.
Any other question?
No.
Okay. Now, I know people are putting their names there. Naona watu wakiandika majina. But don't write. You know, these are online system, the Meet system. Inaweka, inanipea list of those who have joined the class. Na kama ulijin dakika tano na ukatoka, it is still showing me. Ikia dakika tano na wanatoka, it is still... Kwa hivyo nikipeana shule bado itaonyesha uliigia dakika tano na ukatoka. Wenye wanaigia, wanatoka, anaigia tena, anatoka, anaigia, it is still showing that. So, hakuna haja ya kuandika. But what I'll insist. Unajua naona hapa kila mtu anatumia majina nini? Majina saa si official. Try to use official names. Kwa sababu sasa kama umetumia jina si official, unajua kwa shule, because you are passing these things to the school, it will show a different name. So you will not be known that it is you. Naona wengine wametumia majina si official, but many of you have used official name, but some of you have not used official name. Let me mention this one, kwa sababu anachagia sana. I hope the way anachagia divo ame anasikiza. I believe she is listening. Shirowadia. Sasa?
Yes, for.
Sasa wewe umetumia jina si official. Sasa unajua kama mimi sijui Shiro inamaanisha Wajiro. Mwalimu hajui hivyo, unajua atakuwa na issue ku identify you.
Oh, yeah, itabadilisha.
Yeah, try to change so that it is easier for someone to be able to know it is you. So everybody else, I have just used her because for her naelewa hiyo jina yake. But the others, if I don't understand your name na umeishorten, I will not be able to know who you are. And even the school will not be able to know who is this. So please, all of you, try to use official names.
Just a sweet leaf.
Ah, no, don't tell me, kwa sababu utabia kila mwalimu. Please just stage. Sawa. Sinima kuambia these registered in them to school. Kwa hivyo sasa, I cannot even be able to change them, by the way. I can only print them. Kwa sababu inanit system tu inadoa. So, even if you tell me what it means, I'll not be able to change it. Sawa?
Sawa, mwalimu.
Yeah, kuhuwa unaniambia na hapo sijui this means what. Ni sawa mi nitaelewa, but siwezi weza kuchange system. You can only change it on your side.
Okay.
Yeah, and to everybody else, mwenye hajatumia jina official. Now, the class is over, unless there is a question. Kuna mwenye ameniuliza kama tunarudi May. Ni kama ni Shiro ama ni nani na ametoka. She has left. Sijui, mambo ya May sijui, but we are hoping so.
Teacher.
Yeah?
I have a question. Sasa nikichange jina langu kwa official, itachange hiyo, itakuwa kwa zile subjects nimeattend before.
No, it may not change, but at least you'll be on the safer side kwa sababu at least somebody can try to relate. Unaona?
Yeah.
Unasikia? At least
yes,
you can jaribu ku relate. See, umeattend like how many?
Like four.
So, unaona hizo they are a bit few, but now compared to the ones that tutasoma from now, it is better. Kwa sababu, it is better to be identified than people keeping on wondering who is this. Sawa?
Sawa.
Please change. Now, can I go? Now, sasa mwenye ananiambia pastor alisema me. Mimi sijui. I cannot confirm, yes.
Mwalimu.
Yeah?
Rudisha hapo slide 13 kidogo.
Slide 13.
13. Eh. Yeah.
There.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Now, when you are through, tell me to leave the meeting. If I kuna swali ingine. So those joining and leaving, mjua system ina indicate. I can see people joining, leaving, join, leave. The system is indicating the time you joined, the time you left. Then you joined again, then you left. Jaribini, at least you identify kwenu ni wapi kwa kona ka network mzuri. Tunaelewa network, but for your sake still, make sure umejaribu kutafuta ni wapi kwa network sana.
Malima ni namba wifi kwa movie shop. Kwenye nasomea namba wifi kwa movie shop. Kuna hata nanunua movie, so
No, try to sacrifice yourself. Ama uliza mzazi, kama tuseme, listen, kama ukua shule, si ungekuwa unalipa hostel.
Miska angi hostel mimi.
Nakaanga wapi?
Nakaanga kuzo angu fulani sasa mwenye movie shop.
Na sasa sinalipaga fea basi. Awezi titoa hapo. Ika unalipaga fea ama unalaka hoste.
Adi tembe anga kutoka kiganjo adi shule.
Una?
Bandos.
Kiganjo mpaka shule. Alafu nilambia mzae kuhusu wifi. At least ni bayi ataka ni kala kama wifi kadogo wakada hii. Ati masaa.
Bayadu naonyesha. Naonyesha masaa na wifi na wawo.
Sasa, just try to do this. Ubaye ya mandri. Upload to watu ya safari wa mama ya del. Ubaye mandri ya education. It is cheap.
Vanessa na Matea.
Nani si Joy lakini mimi si Joy.
Kwa fala, unajua ni nani?
Yaani Joy uko na crush.
Nani kwa kazi? Ni okay. Mimi si Joy.
Classes tu.
Joy uko na crush.